Last time on Project Catwalk. The brief was set by the glamorous Sophie Ellis-Bextor.
I would like a performance outfit, something fun that I can wear when I'm singing.
Ben challenged the designer's commitment.
If you don't think you've got it, why are you here? Have you given all that you can give?
A model swap created tension.
You're saying Jasper's a right tosser for doing it.
I'm not going to get my own way on this, so sulking will continue.
On the catwalk, Chelsea won her first challenge.
I'm going to cry.
And Clinton's luck finally ran out.
You've been a fabulous contestant on the show. You can now leave the catwalk.
Welcome to the search for the UK's next fashion superstar. 13 talented designers are about to battle it out. Over 9 challenges, they will be tested to the absolute limit, until only 3 are left. The 3 finalists will show their collections during London Fashion Week. But only 1 will win. Their prize, £25,000 in cash. And their own exclusive clothing range, courtesy of Ollie. Plus, a full feature spread in Grazia magazine. 13 designers, 3 finalists, but only 1 winner. Welcome to Project Catwalk.
Once more, just before I'm leaving.
There are now only 5 designers left, and competition for the final 3 places is growing.
Once more, just before.
I think that Ross and Jasper deservedly should be in the final 3, but I think that Viv is going to be there. But I don't think it's deserved. I really don't.
Personally, I don't think the judge did make the right decision. The weakest designer was Viv. She's not a designer yet, she's a dressmaker.
But after 8 weeks away from her family, Viv has other things on her mind.
I'm sort of in a strange place at the moment in terms of home and family, and they're ever present in my thoughts, and, you know, if I think about them for too long, I could burst into tears, and just even talking about them, I can feel it starting, and I've just put my makeup on, so let's not go. Let's not go there. But I'd like to get to the end, really. I would. They'd be so proud, and so would I.
Tell you what, coming this far, I'm pretty much desperate to win it now. I need that prize money, really. So I better bloody win it.
Designers, and welcome back to the catwalk. We are getting closer and closer to finding our 3 finalists, and it's time for me to give you your next challenge. This task is all about mixing functional with fashionable. That's all I'm going to tell you, because soon you'll be hitting the road to meet up with a very special client who'll be giving you a really great brief. Good luck, and I will see you back here on the catwalk.
We all thought that we were off to Paris. We were like, oh, you know. And then we got to Paddington Station and we were on a train heading for Swansea. Like, where are we going?
I thought singing for Sophie last week was bad, but I've got a really bad feeling about this today.
I'm thinking Wales,
bar,
sheep. So maybe we have to design a new farmer's outfit.
I don't think anybody really had any idea what we were going to do, because there were so many conflicting ideas. I'd no idea, really.
So far away, why would they bring us all the way down here?
What is the next?
Guys, we're going towards the airport.
The designers arrive at Exeter Airport, which is home to Flybe, Europe's largest regional airline, employing over 3,000 staff.
I pretty much knew what we'd do when we turned up at the airport. I thought we might have to design an outfit for an airline.
Welcome to Exeter. My name's Niall Duffy. I'm the head of PR and public affairs for Flybe. Our front of house are our cabin crew. The first people that you see when you get on an aircraft are these guys. Now, they're a really important part of the team.
I thought that the uniform needed to be a lot more feminine than it was. Like, a guy could have actually wore that jacket. It was so straight and just... it was just shapeless.
Your task for today is to redesign our uniform for our cabin crew. I want them to look professional. It's got to be practical. It can't be silly. It can't look dated after a year.
I was not all that excited, just because it's a great opportunity, but unless you're given some freedom, where can you really go with it?
For the next few hours, Karen, Dan and Jenny will show you what it's like to be front of house, and I really hope your designs are good, because there's a real possibility that if you come up with something good, we may use it for the next 5 years. That looked fantastic on your CV and it looked great for us as well.
To actually produce something that they might be interested in would be an immense achievement.
OK then, guys, I think we need to go and get you changed.
When we were told that we had to actually be hostesses for the day, I was really excited. Just really love, you know, I love getting dressed up, so I thought, oh, this will be great.
Look at those shoes. I've got a reputation to keep,
mate. I think air hostess uniforms really do need, like, modernising and, you know, judging up a bit.
Yeah, no, I'm keen to change this. It's awful.
Oh, look at that.
We really have to change this uniform, big time.
With the five designers looking the part, it's time to test out the uniforms.
I'll be coming through the cabin with a selection of wine, beers and spirits. Today's hot menu is sirloin steak and pork chops.
Can I get you a drink today?
Wake up, dear.
When we got on the aeroplane and we were actually, you know, in character being air hostesses, I absolutely loved it.
We're waiting for 5 hours for this coffee.
Right.
Could you pour it now for me, please?
I'll pour it over you in a minute if you don't calm down.
Excuse me!
Let me just go and get a senior member of staff.
Jokes aside, it was actually quite useful. Because you could see, you know, if you were put in that situation, how the uniform could restrict you if it was too tight.
Your safety card is in your seat area.
It was actually funny being in the plane because we sort of bonded. We were sort of together and joking around.
Cross the tapes at the back and tie underneath the jacket.
You always take the piss. When you see these poor ladies having to do it and stuff, and it's always quite embarrassing and humiliating for them. And yesterday it was our turn, it was quite good fun, actually. I always wanted to do that.
The jacket is inflated by pulling the red toggle downwards.
Oh, I've had an amazing day. I really enjoyed myself. It's been tremendous fun. I've gained a lot of knowledge about what their job entails and how restriction of movement is obviously a key issue for the garment.
It's going to be a challenge to find something that's fashionable, yet movable.
I'm quite looking forward to the challenge, actually. I've got some quite nice little ideas. It just needs, like, the whole uniform just needs updating. It's really sort of old-fashioned.
The designers have only 2 days to produce an entirely new female cabin crew outfit. So the sketching has to start on the way back to London.
The inspiration came quite quickly. It wasn't a high fashion thing, it had to be commercial. And just to really try and create a new image without this old kind of Queen Mother look they had going on.
I thought this is going to be really hard because it's a whole uniform in the time that we're given. I did panic a bit.
Even on the train, drawing, everybody else is drawing suit jackets and skirts, and I really don't want to do that. And that's why I was, like, kind of sad about it all. I was not enjoying it at all.
Coming up on Project Catwalk, Ben decides to clear the air.
You feel that she doesn't deserve to be here.
A surprise guest pays the designers a visit.
It's not saying to me it's an airline uniform.
And the challenge gets too much for Viv.
Pissed off. Losing the will to live.
This week, the designers were taken on a mystery train journey.
So maybe we have to design a new farmer's outfit.
The tricky brief was set.
Your task for today is to redesign our uniform for our cabin crew.
And the designers got to be cabin crew for the day.
Let me just go and get our senior member stuff.
It's challenge number 8, and it's by far the most technically demanding yet. The designers have to make 3 separate tailored garments in just 20 hours.
I think everybody is aware, just from when the brief was set, how difficult of a challenge this is going to be.
I suppose I do feel technically disadvantaged at this stage because although I've made a jacket before in this competition, it was quite a basic one. It is certainly a proper, true test of my abilities.
Throughout the competition, the others have questioned Viv's design ability. And this week, it's no different.
For me, Viv hasn't got what it takes to be the next big designer.
If Viv's in the final, I don't want to be in the final. I don't think she's ready to create a collection. I don't think it's taking London Fashion Week seriously if Viv's in the final.
With such a demanding task ahead, mentor Ben DeLisi decides to clear the air.
Let's have a little chat. Some of you think you're safe and you're gonna glide through this. As far as I'm concerned, no amount of talent you have makes you safe because someone might really pull it out. You feel that Viv doesn't deserve to be here. Why do you feel that?
Because I think she's a dressmaker and not a designer yet.
And that goes the same thing for you. Just because you are Miss Hotshot and cut a mighty fine pattern, don't underestimate the person who might have a unique talent, just doesn't have your capability of cutting a pattern.
Ben really pissed me off this morning. He really made it seem as if Ross and I really don't think Viv should be here. And I don't think Viv should be here, but I don't think that she needs that on her shoulder. She doesn't need to know that. I think it's a bit out of line, to be honest.
The fact that other people have said things about me, not the fact that I shouldn't be here or should be here, I'm just going to ignore it and pretend it's not been said, because that's all I can do. Because if I dwell on it, it will just send me down, and I'm not doing that.
I mean, I'm cool with whatever Ben says. You know, and I really hope Viv does come back and prove everyone else wrong. And that, you know, she can do it.
Are you allowed to have a hug?
I think having had my chat with them, I think that they understand now that this chance, this opportunity is anyone's. If they don't get this uniform right, their neck is on the chopping block. I won't save them just because they're Jasper or just because they're Ross. So it's a very, very even footing as far as I'm concerned.
This week is a tough one. It's not about fashion, it's about a commercial product.
Some of us were a bit, you know, not so enthusiastic about doing something so plain, really. My stuff's a little too off the wall for airlines, so in order to do well this week, I'm going to have to conform a little bit.
The designers think this brief is all about being commercial, but Ben is sending them a visitor to totally shake up their outlook.
Oh my gosh,
What?
Oh. We're meeting someone, aren't we?
I can give you what you want.
Pam Ann is a well-known comedienne who believes the true spirit of cabin crew outfits lives in the 60s and 70s, when airlines were all about glamour and fashion. What will the designers make of Pam Ann's unique perspective?
I'm Dawson Crosschick, galley secure.
Hello, designers. I'm so excited to be here.
I'm Pam Ann. I've come down to help you with your designs.
Oh, good.
When Pam Ann first walked in, I thought, my goodness, who is this creature? Is she real?
You're a little bit bedazzled by me, aren't you? You're thinking, I wish I'd come up with this idea.
I wish we had that freedom.
Well, you do have that freedom. I think that airline uniforms are boring. And I'm sure Flybe have been teaching you and saying, you know, they need to reach for the overhead locker. I disagree. I think it's all about glamour.
It was a bit sort of down, thinking this is so boring. And then when she came in, she put a bit of life back into us and we were excited again then.
You're young designers, you're making a name for yourself.